If an investment earns 6% compounded monthly, how much would you need to deposit initially for the account to reach $2,000 in 10 years? Well, there are a number of ways to write the formula for compound interest. One way is the amount at the end equals the initial principal times 1 plus I raised to the n power. So again, real quickly, this is the A, the capital A is the ending amount. So I'll write that down so you can refer to that. And P is the initial principal, or I'll say the initial amount. So that is what we're going to be solving for, this P, because it says how much would you need to deposit initially. Over here, I need a little more room to write these. So this I is the periodic interest rate, or it's the annual rate. In our case, that's 6%. Annual rate divided by the number of times it's compounded per year. So I'll just say number of compounds per year. And as long as we're right here, I will just write that out for our problem, and that's 0.06. Again, every time you see a percent, when it goes into a formula, almost always, and this one especially, it goes in as a decimal. So 6% equals 0.06 divided by, it's compounded monthly, so that is 12 times per year. So this I in our problem will equal 0.005. Okay, we've got that. Let's look at the N. N. N equals the number of compounding periods, or you could just say number of periods. So an easy way to think of that is the number of times it's compounded per year times the number of years. So I'll write that out real quickly. Number of compounds per year multiplied by the number of years. Okay, that's N. So in our example, N equals, it's compounded 12 times per year times the 10 years, so 120. And I know you probably already jumped to that, but just to make sure we're all on the same page. Now let's plug in what we know. We know that A, the ending amount, is $2,000. So $2,000 equals the initial amount, which is what we don't know, times 1 plus 0.005, all raised to the 120th power. I would suggest doing that on your calculator, because that would take a while to raise 1.005 to the 120th power. What you get is 2,000 equals P times 1.819967. That's 1.005 raised to the 120th power. There are more decimals. I've just rounded it here. And it's good to hang on to very many, as many as you can. I could have written a little bit more, but for space, I stopped it there. You shouldn't round really until the end. Okay, but I think that'll suffice. Let's divide each side by the coefficient. I'll show that. 1.819396 7, just to belabor the point, 1.819396 7. Okay, we are dividing each side, and we get the initial principal of, I'm going to put the P over here, we would need to put in the grand total of $1,099 and $1,099.27. So if you put in $1,099.27, then, and it's compounded monthly at 6% in 10 years, you'll have $2,000.